In this series, we're going to be building a fully complete character customization system in Godot 4, and in the first episode, we're going to just work on basic character setup with some color changes. So in order to get going on this, we're just going to have a couple of setup things that we're going to have to do. So in our project settings, I have these two installed plugins. They're completely optional, but if you want to install them, you can. But the most important thing is we need to go into our general tab here. We're going to go to window, and we are going to change our viewport width to 1280 by 720. So we're going to have a 16 by 9 resolution. And then we're going to go down into the stretch mode, and we are going to do canvas items in the mode. And in aspect, we are going to do expand. Then the last thing for setup is I'm in compatibility mode. If you're creating a new project, you will want to be in compatibility mode as well. You can use the others, but for our purposes, compatibility mode will be just fine. And along with a little bit other of setup, I already have my assets folder with all the assets that we're going to need that will be in the link in the description. And I'm also going to create a few other new folders, one for our scenes, one for our scripts, and one for our resources. And I think for right now, that should be good. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to go in here and we're going to create a new script. We're going to call this our character data. And it's going to be pretty bare for right now. We are going to actually extend from resource and we're going to give it a class name of character data. And we can actually get rid of all of this other stuff right now. The only thing that we're going to put in here for right now is going to be an export variable for our skin color, which will be of the type color. And we're going to default this to these values here. So 0.98, 0.84, 0.65, and a 1.0 on the alpha. So this color is just going to be a neutral skin tone. It's going to be the base for our character that we're going to be able to change down the road. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to create a new script in our scripts folder. And we're going to call this the customization manager. This is going to be a singleton, so we are going to want to make this an auto load. So this isn't going to get a class name. We're going to go back into our project settings, and in our globals, we're going to go find this script. And we want to make sure that we have this added. Then we can go back here. We're actually going to need our ready method. We're not going to need process. Let's get rid of these comments though. The first thing we're going to add is a color updated signal, which is of the type color. And we're going to get a variable of character data. It's going to be of type character data, which we just created. And then in our ready method, we're going to set our character data equal to a new one. We're going to create a new character data. And we're also going to input some print statements in here just so we can have some helpful hints if anything is going wrong down the road. So we're going to do manager initialized with skin color. And we're going to pass in the character data's skin color. And we're going to have a method called update skin color. And it's going to take in a new color, which is, again, the type color. We're not going to return anything. And all we're going to do here is character data skin color. We're going to set it to the new color, and then we're going to emit our signal. It should be color updated, not color update. Then we'll emit this and the new color. So with all this right now, we can't really do anything with this. We need to actually go in and create our character scene. So we're going to go in, create a new node. It's going to be of the character body 2D type, and we're going to rename this to just be our character. And we're going to need a couple of other nodes in this as well. We're going to need a node 2D, which is just going to be a container for all of our sprites. And then we are going to give this a collision shape. And then we need to go in here and add a sprite 2D inside of our sprites container. And what we're going to do here is go into our assets. We're going to assign the base to this texture. We're going to make sure it's centered. The offset, this is all fine. The H frames that we need to do though is it is going to be 8 wide. So there are going to be 8 frames if we reset this. There are 8 frames here. So we just want to set that to 8. And the V frames, 8x8. And then we're going to add our collision shape. Sorry, we're going to do a rectangle. And it doesn't really, we're not really doing any collision shape. We're just going to get rid of the errors that are in, or the alerts that are in, because a character body 2D does require collision shape. So we're just going to assign this so we don't get any alerts over here. Let's save this into our scenes folder. And then we want to attach a script to it, which is going, oh, not to the collision shape 2D. We want to attach it to the character. We'll give this a class name of character. And we can get rid of everything here also. We're not going to need any of this code. We're going to have one onReady variable, which is going to be our sprite 2D, which I'm actually going to rename to our base. So let's onReady this, and we will call this our base sprite. Then we need to create our ready method. And we're just going to worry about updating colors for right now. We can tap into our customization manager. We're going to hit the color updated signal and connect to it. And we're going to make this down the road. It's going to be on color updated. So let's just create this method as a bare bones with a pass, just so we have this and we don't get the errors. And then we're going to also have to create this method, but we're going to create a method called update color. We're going to pass in the customization manager's character data and then get the skin color. Okay, so let's also build out update color, which is going to take in a color of the type color, and we're not going to return anything. In the on color updated, all we're going to do is update color. And then down here, okay, so in on color updated, we are also taking in a color. Bad there. We pass in the color here, and then we go into our base sprite. We're going to modulate it with this color. Okay, so now we should be able to test this scene. Okay, we have no errors. Our character is over here, just up in that top left, because we haven't moved them. So everything's connected. We get an error in the debugger, which is opening. Okay, that's unrelated, so we can ignore that. Now we need to start building some of the basic UI elements. And the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to create what we're going to call our customization panel. So let's create a new scene. It's going to be not a control. It is going to be a panel. And we're going to rename this to be customization panel. We're going to create a theme, which we're going to use across. So let's create this new theme. And we need to go in and we're going to have to add panel here. So we're going to need this style box flat here. We're going to create a new style box flat. Click into this. And we're going to use a hex code of 1E1E1E. It's sort of a, yeah, this black-ish color. We're also going to have a corner radius of 8, just to give it some softer edges. And we're going to come back to this theme and update it down the road. But for right now, this should be good. So let's save this, and we'll call this our UI theme. And we can save this. It's probably not really a resource, but I guess it is a resource. So let's save it into our resources folder. Okay, so now our customization panel has this UI theme. Let's close this. And what we're going to do now is we want to go in and we have to set some layout changes. So we want this to be full rect. That's good that we're already there. So I guess we actually don't. Since we're already in full rect, we don't have to make any changes here right now. But what we are going to do is we're going to add a margin container node as a child. We're going to go into theme overrides for our constants here, and we're going to give this some margins of 16 across the board. And then as a child, we're going to give it a color picker button. So don't choose the color picker. We want the color picker button. And we're going to give it a custom minimum size. So we want to go into our layout, and the custom minimum size is going to be 200 by 40. And the color is going to be equal to our default skin tone. We're going to be assigning this in code though, so we don't need to worry about this right now, at least for the moment. But now we are going to need to add a script to this. So we can create our customization panel script, but we are going to save it inside of scripts. We're not going to give this one a class name. We are going to, this theme keeps popping up. We are going to give this an onReady. We're going to, why does this keep popping up? All right, save, close. All right. We're going to need our ready method. In our ready method, we're going to go to the color picker, color. So we don't, that's why we don't have to assign the color earlier. We're going to go have this be equal to our customization manager, our character data, and the skin color. So let's save this. And then I'm going to restart my project. Maybe this will stop popping up. So give me 1 second. Okay, I hope that fixed it. I had to Google a little bit as to, I think when this is open, it keeps popping up. So hopefully now that this is pushed down, it won't keep popping up. But regardless, next thing we need to do is we need to tap in to our signal. So we need to tap in to the color change signal, and we're going to connect. And then we're going to make a method for onColorChanged, which we need to make right now. And what we're going to do here is go into our customization manager. We're going to update the skin color and pass in the color. And on that note, we are also passing in the color. So make sure that you're passing in this variable into this method for the onColorChanged. Okay, so now here we go. We actually have, if we go in and run this as a test scene, we have a color picker that we can actually select from. Okay. Okay, still the same debugger, weird debugger error for the icon. Don't need to worry about that. Actually, I think I can fix that real quick. Don't need an icon here. Okay, save that. Now we need to actually build out the main scene or the main node so that we can actually put this all together. Okay, so we are going to make another node, and it can be a user. It actually is going to be a control, so you can just do the user interface node. We're just going to call this main. We're going to give it our theme. We want to make sure that it is full rect, which it should be. And then we're going to add some child nodes. We're going to have an hsplit container. As a child of this, we're going to have something that is called a sub viewport container, which is going to have a child of a sub viewport. And then outside of this sub viewport stuff, but still a child of the hsplit container, we want to drag in our customization panel scene. Let's drag this script in here. Customization panel is going to be here. Okay, now let's save this. We're going to call this our main scene. We're going to save. Okay, wonderful. Nothing to change in our hsplit, but we do need to go into our sub viewport container, which I am going to rename as just preview. We need to go into our layout mode, our container sizing, and we are going to want this to be expand. And then inside of our sub viewport, we have to update a couple things here where we want a transparent background. And that is actually the only thing we have to do here. And then we need to drag our character to be under as a child of the sub viewport. Then we're going to go back to our character script. And we're going to set up a new variable. We're going to call it isPreview, which is going to be a Boolean, which we default to false. And we're going to create a method called setAsPreview, which does not take in any variables and it doesn't return anything. We're going to set isPreview to true. We're going to set physicsProcess false, since we're not applying any physics here. And then we can actually make another onReady variable for our sprites here. We're going to do sprites.scale. We're going to equal to vector 2. And we're going to do 3, 3. Okay, so let's go and test this out. Okay, so our character is still all the way over here, but you can see on the left, let me adjust the character inside of here. Okay, whatever the collision shape is not important. Let's pop it there. Okay, and let's go and look at this main scene. There he is, really tiny. You can see this color picker is actually working now. So this is a start. This is a very basic start for us right now, where we have a working color picker. Our sprite is there. The design is not, but we're going to get there. So before we wrap up this video, we're going to add just some more debugging and some other polish and cleanup before we call this video a wrap. In Customization Manager, we're going to add some print debugger and push error and push warning messages here. So the first thing we're going to look for is if there isn't character data. We're going to do a push error. And we're going to get no character data available. Then if new color.a is less than 1.0, we're going to do a push warning. It says color alpha ignored for skin tone. And then we're going to new color a is going to equal 1.0. So we're just going to give us some hints here as to, you know, if something's going wrong or something's going weird, we're just going to give ourselves some warnings. Then in character, we're going to tap in to a draw built-in method. It's if os.isDebugBuild and engine.isEditorHint. We're going to draw rect, move a rect to. I'm going to do -16, -16, 32, 32. We're going to do color.red and false. And then lastly, we're going to go back to our customization panel, and we are going to create a method called setup presets, which doesn't do anything. So we are going to get a variable, which we've called our presets, and they're going to be equal to just a couple of our standard skin tones that we're going to have, which you can always expand on. So a light skin tone can be 0.98, 0.84, 0.65. We're going to do, we just copy this and we'll change the values. And then for a medium shade, we'll do 0.85 by 0.65. And 0.45. And then for a darker tone, we'll do 6.5, 4.5, and 2.5. Then below that, we need to loop through these. So for color in our presets, we'll do color picker dot get picker dot add preset color. So we're not doing anything with that right now, but we have a good base here, and I think this is going to be a several video long series. So I think this is a good place to stop, where we have a basic color picker inside of our main scene where we can get our player to be changed. I think this is a good place to stop for right now. So stay tuned for the next video.